Kevin, did you know?
Yes.
Great praise messed me up. So much. Inviting us to your part.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you for the invitation. Now, God, we need to hear from you. We need a word. Just give us a word for this hour. Someone needs a word from on high.
Ooh, thank you. Son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Right.
And they were in the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
Right.
For unto you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God, and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. I'd like to speak into your hearing this morning the greatest gift of all. The greatest gift of all. I'd like to hit five brief areas this morning, which gives us the outline, if you will, for the holiday season. I'd like to talk to you about expectation, for those who are taking notes. Expectation, visitation, salvation, liberation, and then celebration.
All right.
Expectation, visitation, salvation, liberation, and then celebration. I was at the airport last year. We preached in New York for Christmas and Watch Night service last year. And I flew out of Tampa, and I'm at the airport, you know, when you buy the gate.
there was this little boy that was just playing around, you know, running to and fro. He was like, what they call it, AD, seemed like he might have had ADHD. Just couldn't sit still. And in walks this couple to the gate, this man and this woman, and the woman was pregnant. Amen. And the little boy, I named him Johnny, I don't know if that was his name. But little Johnny, when he saw the woman, the pregnant woman, he stopped. He didn't move. He kept staring at her stomach. Amen. Someone said there's something special about children with pregnant women. Sometimes a child can just look at you and be mesmerized. Amen. But I want to kind of be like Johnny, and the church ought to be like little Johnny sometimes. Amen. We ought to stare, amen, and put our focus, amen, on something that God has impregnated.
All right, now.
All right.
All right.
Yeah, missed that. Amen. You see, amen. The problem with a lot of churches today is that nobody is expecting anything.
All right now. Come on.
And anytime the Holy Ghost is pregnant, can I get a witness? There ought to be somebody that's expecting something.
Yes. Right. Amen. Come on. I got you.
Amen.
Amen.
And John is like almost like an angel. He knows when there's something, amen, inside of you, amen, that's growing that God wants to deliver.
Amen.
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 When was the last time you were pregnant with something? Come on, somebody. Look, I might seem a little bit different, amen. My ankles might be a little swollen. Can I get a witness? I might have a few stretch marks, amen. Help me, Holy Ghost. But it is because God has put something in me. Come on, somebody. I'm expecting, amen. Look, are there any pregnant folks in the house? Anybody expecting anything, the Lord to do anything in your life, amen. I need the Lord, amen, to impregnate me, amen, with destiny. Mount Zion, you little Johnny, might as well come and stare at this building because you are pregnant.
Yes,
you know that, amen?
Amen.
You're pregnant. You're pregnant. This is a strange story here. In Luke, amen. Because there's a woman by the name of Mary.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Which really she was more a young girl than she was a woman.
Right.
But she certainly was changing. Amen.
Amen.
Look, see, when God, amen, is growing in you,
yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Your spiritual features, amen, ought to change.
Yes, yes.
Come on, somebody. When the triune God is in you, amen, you ought to have a first semester, a trimester, a second trimester, and a third trimester. She's pregnant. But what is odd about it is that she's a virgin.
All right.
Amen.
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 See, the angel had to come to her, but he also had to come to Joseph.
Yes.
Let's put ourselves there. You're engaged to somebody. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And the angel come to you and say that you are now pregnant. Come on, son. My natural, how could it be? How could that be? Amen. I don't quite understand the biology of it.
Right.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
But see, what I love about God is that he doesn't move in our definition of biology. Or he doesn't move in our definition of the natural.
Okay.
He moves in the supernatural.
Yeah. Right.
I mean, tell somebody, your natural situation might not line up with the fact
that you are pregnant, amen, with something that's greater than you. And people are going to remind you of your natural situation. Come on, can I get a witness? But the Bible says that with God, amen, nothing shall be impossible.
Angel tells Joseph, "Be cool, man. This ain't anything like scandal. This ain't one of those programs, amen. What's in her, amen, is of the Holy Ghost. It's not playtime. It's of the Holy Ghost. So what you have to do, Joseph, you have to make sure that she brings, amen, the seed to term. Amen. Don't worry about whose it is. God said it's mine. Amen. And you need to be able to tell somebody, don't worry about who I am or what I am. I'm His. Can I get a witness? I belong to Him. Amen. All that I am, all that I'm not, all that I have, all that I don't have, I owe it all to Him.
So here's Jesus and Joseph and Mary. Pregnant. Getting ready to deliver. And still a virgin. Somebody said miraculous. That's what I love about God. He can move in the miraculous. Amen. Do you believe God for the miraculous? Are you expecting God for the miraculous? Amen. Because with man it's impossible. But with God it's possible. All you have to do is touch and agree. Amen. And receive it by faith. Can I get a witness? I'm just crazy enough to believe what God said. Can I get a witness? It don't matter where I am. If the Lord said it. So they're in the city of David, Bethlehem. Joseph had to pay taxes. Amen. And there's so many people at the in the city of David at this time to pay taxes that when they went to the local inn, amen, there was no room. Can you imagine there being no room for Jesus? Amen. But before we look at that, amen, with disbelief, amen, let me ask you my first point in the form of a question. Do you have room for Jesus? Come on, somebody. Out of your busy life, out of your gifts, amen, out of your good looks, amen, out of the job you have, the car you drive, the intelligence God has blessed you with all of that, do you have room for Jesus? If Jesus wants to come into your life, is there any room for Him? Come on, somebody. Can I get a witness? Look, what they should have done is made some room for Jesus. You have to make some room for Jesus. Can I get a witness? And some of us need to delete some other things out of our life and make some room for Jesus. Jesus is telling you, I want to come in. Amen. But you're crowded with all sorts of other things. Amen. If you would just put some things out of your life and make some room for me. Is there any room? Do you have room for Jesus? Or do you just take Jesus off the shelf? Amen. Put him in your pocketbook. And bring him to church on Sunday. Amen. Or some of us leave him in our car. Amen. It's hot. Jesus is in the car. You got the windows all hot. It's just hot. Amen. Some of us got him in our closet. Can I get a window? Some of us are hiding Jesus. But do you have room for Jesus? Do you have room? Amen. If you was arrested for being a Christian, would there be enough evidence to convict you? They had to put him in what was available. Somebody had a little barn with a feeding trough for the animals. Amen. But aren't you glad
that God will use what's available.
Amen.
Amen. It doesn't matter what it is.
Right.
That's right.
He's not looking for a capability.
That's right.
He's looking for availability.
Go ahead.
Come on.
Are you available? It doesn't matter. Come on, somebody. You may be a feeding trunk for wild beasts.
Right.
But are you available? Lord, if you can use all that, this is all I have. But if you can use it, Lord, it's not much. Can I get a witness? But if you can use it, amen, it's yours.
Amen.
Lord, I'm not much.
Oh, Lord.
But if you can use me,
oh, Lord,
I'm yours.
Right.
I'm not perfect, amen. There's still a little wild beast in me.
Yes,
can I get a witness?
Yes,
and some animal dung or some bull.
Oh, yes.
Easy, my reason. Some of us are still full of a little. Some of us have a little stuff in our life. Can I get a witness?
Come on,
and don't act like yours don't stink. Watching over their flock.
Right.
By night.
Mm-hmm.
Do you imagine that's odd?
Yes, it is.
Because normally shepherds don't watch over their flock by night.
Mm-hmm.
They bed the flock down.
Amen.
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 But for some reason, in the midnight hour,
somebody
was watching.
Yes. Right.
Somebody was in expectation. My second point in the form of a question is, are you living in expectation?
Yeah.
Are you in position?
Amen.
Amen. Or are you sleeping when you're supposed to be awake?
Oh.
Sometimes God will wake you up in the middle of the night, amen, just to talk to you, amen. He'll wake you up at 3 a.m. just to talk to you. And you ought to be able to say, Lord, your servant heareth, amen. Sometimes he wants you to just get up out of bed. Maybe sit on the side of the bed. If you were too busy during the day to hear him, and sometimes he wants to get you in the middle of the night. Has God any talk to anybody in the midnight hour?
Yeah.
Only talk in the midnight hour, amen. He will tell you something in the midnight hour. If he wakes you up in the midnight hour, pay attention. So that's it, Pastor Gene. I was wondering why it kept happening. Amen. For 3 nights in a row, he woke me up at 3 o'clock in the morning. He's trying to tell you something. What you need to do is listen to God. He's trying to show you something. Amen. He's a show and tell type of
God. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
They're expecting, so they're abiding in the field. And that's what God wants you to do. He wants you to abide in the field.
Amen.
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 He wants you to be abiding in the field that he's placed you in.
All right.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Some of us are too busy abiding in the wrong field.
Come on, Jeff.
You wonder why everything, amen, is backwards and running crazy because you're in the wrong field. Church, your neighbor say, are you in the wrong field? You got to be in position, amen. The enemy wants to take you and keep you, amen, out of position. Some of y'all ain't in the right position. Can I get a witness? You in the wrong lane. Can I get a witness? Abide in your field.
Watch that now.
That just jumped in my spirit.
Somebody.
One thing about God, amen, he knows the field you're supposed to be in. He wants you to be in position. So when he's ready, amen, to speak, amen, into your life, you are in position. The enemy wants to keep you out of position, amen. But what expectation is, look, make sure that you're in the right position.
All right.
something that happened earlier. The angel that came into Mary and said, "Hey, thou art highly favored. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women."
Yes.
My third point in the form of a question is, do you know you are blessed?
Amen.
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 God is looking for some folks who know that are blessed. Amen. Somebody in here knows that if it had not been for the Lord, he was on my side. Amen. Look, I know I'm blessed. That don't make me conceited. Amen. I just know that I'm blessed because I know the blessor. Amen. See, it's not actually in the blessing. It's actually in the blessor. Amen. I ain't saying I deserve it. Amen. But he found me where I was. Can I get a witness? And he blessed me right there where I was. Can I? That's why my worship is for real. Because my worship is not predicated on my own capability. My worship is real because God said everything is going to be all right. God said, amen, you are highly favored. Can I get? And somebody said, favor ain't fear. I ain't trying to say it's fear, but it's my reality. I'm blessed. And you need to know that you're blessed. We got too many people that don't know how blessed they are. Amen. Look, you are blessed. He woke you up this morning. He started you on your way. Can I get a witness? He impregnated you with purpose. You are blessed. And if you weren't blessed, you wouldn't even have woke up this morning. The reason why you're sitting in this church right now is because God is blessing you. He's blessing you right now. Some of us just ain't got sense enough to understand God's blessings. Amen. Just because you don't have everything you're supposed to have don't mean that you're blessed. But God is looking for people who know that they're blessed and who know who blessed them. Trouble that the angel said, "I'm blessed." Then she cast in her mind, what man of salutation is this coming to me? See, a lot of us, we know that we don't do it all right. We know, amen, that we have flaws. Amen. Look, if God, if being flawless was a requirement to be a child of God, the church would be empty. The pews would be preaching to themselves. Amen. God hasn't blessed you because you're all that.
All right. Shut up.
But God so loved the world that he gave. I can't explain why he loved me, but I'm so glad that he does. Come on, somebody. I'm not crazy enough to think that I deserve it. Amen. But he got two cousins named Grace and Mercy. And every now and then, the two cousins come and see about me. Can I get a witness? Anybody ever had a visit from the two cousins? Amen. It's because of God's grace and his mercy. Amen. It's because of his grace and his mercy. You wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the two cousins.
All right.
All
right.
He said, don't be afraid. But I appreciate you, Mary, for keeping it real. Because some of us don't keep it real.
All right, now. All right, brother.
Amen. And God wants you to keep it real.
Keep it real.
You know why he made you flawless? So you can learn how to lean and depend on him.
All right. Thank you, Lord.
Look what he does to her next. He said, "Fear not, Mary." Uh-oh. He knows your name. He knows your name. And if he knows your name, he knows your situation.
That's right.
He knows your limitation.
Amen.
It ain't about you.
It's about what I'm about to put in you. Amen. You have rise in your DNA because of the God that you serve. Can I get a witness? God is looking for humble people. Amen. Not perfect people, humble people. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
So that you can be all that you're supposed to be, knowing who empowers you. Amen. I am all that I am because of the power of God. Whatever I hope to be will have to be done by the power of God. Because if the truth be told, I am not worthy. Amen. But He's worthy. Can I get a witness? That's why I can worship Him the way I do. Because sometimes I don't even understand, amen, what kind of salutations He puts on me. But one thing I know how to do is say, Lord, I don't deserve it. Amen. But if you want to bless me, any way you bless me, I'll be satisfied. Any way you deliver me, I'll be satisfied. I'm yours, Lord.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
He says, this is who here is.
Thank you, Lord.
You have found favor.
Yes.
My fourth point is, do you know that you have favor with God?
Oh, wow.
Amen. Look, the reason why you're still here is because of faith. Amen.
Amen.
The reason why God didn't take you out yet is because of faith. Amen. You have been chosen for such a time as this. There's only something that you can do. Amen. You can't have two people pregnant with the same baby. I got my own baby. Can I get a witness? And when she went to see Elizabeth, Elizabeth had her own baby. What was in Mary caused what was in Elizabeth to leap. Can I get a witness? And I'm so glad that God knows how to stir up whatever is in me. And everything, every now and then I get a reminder, every man, you feel a gift kicking. Can I get a witness? Oh yeah, I'm pregnant. Every now, that gift will kick you in the middle of the night. That gift will kick you when you're sitting in church. That gift will kick you when you're driving your car. Every now and then, what's in you will let you know it's in you. And when it kicks, amen, the least you can do is lift up hands and start worshiping God. When it kicks, the least you can do is say, Lord, I thank you. When it kicks, the least you can do is say, have your own way, Lord. Thank you for putting it in. For such a time as this, the greatest gift of all. Isaiah said it like this: for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor. Now see, this wonderful ain't the same wonderful we use. Because we say a lot of things are wonderful.
All right.
Hey, amen. We just had a wonderful time.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Oh, that was just a wonderful sermon this morning.
Yeah.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
But when God says wonderful.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
When we describe wonderfulness to God, it also has a sense of wonder and a sense of awesomeness in it. Can I get a witness? Sometimes I wonder, amen, how could a God love a wretch like me? Amen. It's a wonder to my soul, amen, that He can come to see about me. Can I get a witness? To see about my unworthy self. To see about my sinful self. To see about my dark self. I'm so glad that He's wonderful, amen, because it has a part of wonderness about it. The mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. My final question is, do you have a reason to worship Him?
Yes, sir.
We say that Jesus is the reason for the season. Can I give you a part two to that. Not only is Jesus the reason for the season, watch this. I'm going to say something to you you'll never forget. You are also the reason for the season.
Amen.
The Bible says that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Come on, somebody. That whosoever should believe in him should not perish. And when the angels gave the announcement to the shepherds, the angels said, unto you. Unto you is born this day in the city of David. He came to 42 generations. For you, he was born in a manger. Amen. All around wild beasts and everything for you. Amen. He walked this earth for 33 and a half years for you. He was wounded for your transgression. He was bruised for your iniquities. Can I get a witness? And the chastisement of our peace was upon him. Amen. He was hung and they stretched him wide for you. Can I get a witness? He bled for you. He died for you. But not only was he bleeding, and not only did he die and stay in the grave for 3 days, but early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hands for you. No. If he did all that for me, the psalmist says, what can I render unto the Lord? What can I give him? Come on, can I get a witness? What can I bring to his party? Some of us, we want to get, but we don't want to give. Can I get a witness? But God requires something for you. He wants everything. He wants your worship. He wants your praise. He wants your life. Amen. Give him your life today. We can't give him what he gave us. Amen. But he gave us life. And he gave us life more abundantly. We have a reason to praise him. You want to think about what he wants from you. Don't wait to January 1st to make a New Year's resolution. Now is the acceptable time. He's the greatest gift of all. You can't beat his giving. The more you give, the more he'll give to you. What shall I render? What can I give him? As we stand on our feet, he wants all of you. And we celebrate. Because with his visitation he came, he brought about salvation.
Yes.
I'm saved. Anybody else saved? Anybody else been set free? Look, if you haven't been set free yet, if you haven't been saved yet, come up now. Just come up now. Just come on. Just if you know that you haven't given the Lord your life yet, come on now. Come on his party. Give him your life as a gift. Come on. He wants you. He wants all of you. Give him your life. Give him your life. He came for you. You're the reason for the season. Thank you, Lord. Is there one? Thank God he loves us. Thank God he loves us.
Hallelujah.